गुड आफ्टरनून सर।
वेरी गुड आफ्टरनून। ओके गाइस, टुडे योर लेक्चर इज ऑन फूड एंड बेवरेज सर्विस मैनेजमेंट एंड द टॉपिक इन दिस लेक्चर इज योर सेल्स एंड कॉस्ट एनालिसिस। हाउ वी डू सेल्स एंड कॉस्ट एनालिसिस इन एनी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन। आफ्टर डूइंग दिस लेक्चर, आफ्टर स्टडीइंग दिस लेक्चर, व्हाट यू विल लर्न फ्रॉम दिस और व्हाट आउटकम वी गेट after doing this lecture, you will got to know about the sales system which is used in any restaurant or in any hospitality industry, and also for the same and how we calculate the costing of products, of raw material, and how we purchase that particular products. Okay, how we calculate all the salaries of our, or we can say that our wages which we are paying to our employees, that we will understand about that. Okay, deeply understand about that. Okay, cost. Basically, cost. What is cost? Cost is defined as a reduction in the value of an asset for the purpose of securing benefits or gains. Like reduction of like whatever we get after preparing some raw material and deducting all the, you can say that waste from that, and what the actual outcome we get, and on what particular value, on what particular value we are serving or selling some you can say that items, or you can say that if we talk about our industry, hospitality industry, eatables, or providing services for the for, you can say that for the for guests, okay, and securing some benefit, okay, after selling something or providing some service to the guest, we get some benefits or gains. Okay, that is called actually cost. Okay, in F&B service terms, it means the price for the goods and services when goods are consumed and services are rendered. Like in our industry, or in F&B industry, you can say that in hospitality industry, what we can say about the costing is, costing means the price for the goods, whatever the goods we are consuming, whatever the dishes, you can say that, or you can say whatever the kind of, if we talk about the rooms, okay. So whatever we are using in that particular rooms, rather maybe beverages or maybe any kind of food, okay, like amenities, guest amenities, what we are using and paying for that, okay, and services like some particular employer of that particular hotel serving some food to us or providing some services, cleaning our rooms, okay, providing rooms, rooms, guiding towards our rooms. Okay, for that we just say that are the cost. Okay, or that are the price for that particular things. Okay, and goods are consumed, whatever the goods we consume and whatever the services we are rendering. Okay, whatever the services we are taking from that particular organization or from that particular hotel, that is called cost. Or whatever the value we are paying for that, okay, in terms of maybe check, through credit card, or you can say that through credit card, or maybe through your cash, okay, by traveler's check, maybe that is called cost. Cost is defined as an excrement of cost relating to a suitable unit of output. Like whatever we are consuming at any place, okay, that particular, you can say that organization or that particular business sector, whatever the selling, on what price, okay, or on suitable price, whether it is maybe very much costly or not very much costly or maybe cheap, okay, that all depends upon the costing. Okay, if we talk about this line, costing is defined as the ascertainment of cost relating to a suitable unit of output. Like if we can say that if we are taking some service, or you can say that some kind of service, or some kind taking some rooms from the hotel, or hiring some rooms, okay, or we are checking in some kind of rooms, okay. So that rooms are particularly the value of that particular rooms are based on their services and goods, whatever the goods they are providing. Like if we talk about, if we are taking only single room, or the, you can say that basic room from the hotel, they may charge us 4,000 or 5,000 for that. But if we are taking suite room, okay, in which all your mini bar, your kitchen setup, living area, and your, you can say that your dining tables and all the, you can say that amenities and services are very well lavished, okay. So for that room, we have to pay 10,000, or maybe for 15,000 for that room. So that are only that suitable price for the unit, means ki like whatever the output we are coming from that, okay, what output, like what services they are providing us for that particular value, that is called cost. Any confusion? Yes guys, any confusion in this topic, like cost? I think so there is no confusion. So we will move forward to the next slide. Classification of cost. Like there are different types of cost, fixed, variable. Okay. So fixed cost, basically whatever the amount, or the, you can say that costing, you can say, or the charges. Okay. What we have to pay on fixed period of time, okay, that are not changed. They may be increased but not decreased, okay, according to the time frame. They may increase but not decreased, okay. So that are the fixed prices, but in variable they may be fluctuate, okay, depending upon the market rates, or you can say that depending upon the current scenario, or depending upon the demand of that particular product, they may fluctuate. Okay, so fixed cost. But first we talk about the fixed cost. What is the fixed cost? Is these costs remains unaffected by the changes in the turnover of any establishment. Like if we say that, like if we are paying some kind of rent or some kind of insurance to anyone, okay, so there is no any, you can say that fluctuation, or you can say that increase or decrease or decline, okay, in the charges, or you can say that the costing of that particular products, okay, whether the turnover is maybe get decrease or maybe get increase according to the time frame. Okay, so that only you can say that are the things which are fixed. Okay, so they remain fixed over a period of times. Like I already told you, they may be increased after some time frame. Time frame means like after 5 years or after 10 years, but they never decrease. Okay, so like for that, there are very good examples, like insurance, rents, labor cost, and etc. So these are the, you can say that like water supply bills may be in this, okay, the renovation charges may be, you can include in this, okay, that may be that will be, you can say that fixed. Okay, you have to pay insurance if you are taking the insurance for the particular period of time. Okay, you have to pay after maybe a 6 month, after a 1 year. Mostly insurances are coming, the term, the time frame, or you can say that the terms of insurance are coming in the year, on the year basis. But some people may prefer 3 months, after three paying their premium after 3 months, or maybe after 6 months. So they remain same, okay, because the value of your property, okay, that will be increasing day by day, not decreasing day by day. Okay, so that will be the same if you are paying the insurance for your employees, employees in your hotel, that again the same you have to pay the premium for that, okay, rents. If you are taking the place where you are set up your hotel, that is on lease basis, okay, maybe on lease maybe, or maybe on rental basis. So in that you can see that the rent are coming after a month, okay. So that are again same, whether you are selling your products or not, or your maybe you can say that your turnover is good or not, that doesn't matter. But you have to pay your rent at the end of your month or at the starting of the month, okay. Then your labor cost. Labor cost may be fluctuate, but most of the labors or the permanent labor which you are from where you are taking work from them, okay. So permanent labors are the same. You have to pay their bills, or you can say that pay their salaries after 1 month or end of the month, okay. So these are the fixed cost. And if we talk about water supply bills, okay, that are again same. The fixed amount of that particular water supply, that again you have to pay for that, okay. Then next is your variable cost. Variable cost, which changes in direct proportion to the sales, they increase with the increase in sale and decrease with the decrease of sale. Like variable cost, they may be that may be changed according to the sale, on the sale perspectives, okay. If the sale is increasing day by day, then your variable costs or the cost of your food, beverages are again increasing day by day, because if you have to sell or if you have to provide the service or actual quantity of food to the customers, you have to buy food on daily basis, beverages on daily basis to fulfill the demand of the guest, okay. So in that case, the variable cost may be change or direct proportion to the sales. Like direct proportion means ki like that is directly connected with the sale point of view, okay. If the sale is increased, okay, then your product demand increase automatically. If your sale is decreased, then your demand of the products, whatever you are selling, that may be then again decrease, okay. So that are the best examples, food cost and beverage cost, okay. Again, if we talk about variable cost, fuel cost again in come in this, like if you are preparing food for like so many people for the in your hotel, sorry. So again, if the cost of food and beverage cost increase, automatically your fuel cost is again increase, whether you are using LPG or whether you are using biogas and that, or any kind of electronic appliances, okay. So again, electricity bills are also are your variable cost, okay. That also may increase, okay, by if the check-ins are increased in your hotel, okay, or in your industry, okay. So consumption of electricity automatically increase, okay. Any confusion, guys, in this? Any confusion in classification of cost? Yes, Akash, I think you have to mute yourself. I think you are in a lecture. Yes, Akash, I'm talking to you. Okay, the next slide is again continue with the classification, semi-variable costs. So these are some of the categorized, what I'm talking about, the fuel, electricity, telephone expenses. These are some of the semi-variable costs, they categorize into it, okay. These costs change with the change in the sale. Again, change with the sale, again, but not in the direct direct proportion, but not your variable cost is directly proportion with the sale, but semi variable cost is not directly proportion with the sale perspective. Reason behind, because you can say that the electricity bills and telephone expense, these are the, you can say that basic using things which we have to use, okay, whether your sale is increasing or decreasing, because you have to call to your customers, to your clients, or you can say that to your employees also, okay. Electricity bill, you have to may minimize to some point, okay, but the electricity bill, the whatever the basic criteria or basic consumption you have to pay for that, that bill, okay, if the consumption of electricity may exceed, then you you have to pay much from the basic price, whatever the basic price is decided for that particular property, okay. But the basic price for the electricity you have to pay, whether your sale is going on or not, okay, whether your guest is coming or not, okay. Again, if we talk about the fuel again, if fuel are generating it, consuming at various places, like your generators, in your generators, like in your delivery cars, or you can say that in your taxis. So these are the semi-variable costs, you may take that, which are not directly proportioned with the sales, but you can say that it may affect with the sale, but not directly, okay. Next is your sale analysis. A sale analysis is a detailed report that shows business sale performance as well as customer data and generate revenue. Like a sale analysis report, you may say that, okay, in which there is a lots of details, okay. Basically, what sale, why we do sale, or we can say that why we create a sales report, okay, because we can get all the data and performances maybe in the graph form, or in the pie chart form, or maybe in the figures form, okay. And as well as we also get the data and generate the revenue, like getting the data by the sales, okay, whatever the sale report you prepare, okay, like if we talk about, we are taking we are collecting reports from different departments, okay, like we can collect from front office, then your restaurant, okay, again from your tour counter maybe, okay, okay, or GRA guest, okay. So we just collect all the data of the customer and create one report that is called sale analyzed report, okay, in which we can see that how many guests are check-in in our hotel, and how many guests are in the restaurant for this month or for this week, okay, and how many guests who are living or in-house guests in our hotel and visiting to the bar or to the restaurant. So we just calculate all the, you can say, the data, or we just collect or gather all that data, and then we start doing work onto that, okay, by generating, how we can generate revenue again from that. We just give a call to them, okay, by giving call, we just ask if the that particular guest is local, then we again invite providing or sorry, offering some kind of, you can say that, different offers to them, different discounts to them, okay, if they are they booked any kind of wedding or any kind of get together over there in past, which we in past few months, or the data we collected, we again offer them the same or some better, or some better, you can say that, offer to them. So by this, we just generate revenue, again generate revenue from that report. The report defines the strength and weaknesses of the product, okay, weakness of product and sales teams by referencing historical and current metrics to detect emerging trends that are most relevant to a company. So this again helps in very different ways these sales analyze report, how it helps, we can just pick up our strengths. Okay, like if we talk about our strength is our, you can say that our bar, or you can say that the restaurant in which the 10 to 20 items which we are serving over there, that are, that all are in limelight. Okay, so by that, what we can do, we just put more efforts onto on that on our strengthened part, and checking out our weaknesses of the products, what weak products we are selling. Okay, so we just start doing work onto on that products also. Okay, because strengths are good, we know that strengths we have, and we can generate this much revenue by these strengths. Okay, but if we talk about our weaknesses, if there are some weaknesses, if that weaknesses are also converted into our strength, then again our revenue increase or go up by 20 to 25%. Okay, so that's why we just collect all the data and all the performances, and then start doing work onto that. And again, this all tasks are done by our sales team by referencing the all historical and current meritics. Okay, so we just take all the data and start doing study on that. Okay, historical data, like what previous year, we can also go on our previous year. Like this previous year, we do 50% of sale from our restaurant, but this year we do 70%. And in the next year or in the coming few months, we have to achieve the target of 90%. Okay, so these are the process, or these are the, you can say that some of the efforts, you may say that, or you can say that strategies. Best word for this are strategies we prepare for the upcoming months or for the upcoming year, that we can do this and we can do this, and we provide these offers to the guests that also may called as a marketing skills. Okay, so marketing skills, we can say that to detect the merging trends, like what merging trends, like what trends like today is very much in the limelight in current market, or other restaurants or other hotels are using. Okay, we may do better from that also. Okay, we are not copying that particular you can say that trends, but we can do better. Okay, so our performance, or you can say that our sales get increased. Okay, and that are most relevant to the company, like what trends and what strategies we can follow, or we just give advice on that, which are very much beneficial for our company. Okay, so this is the process way to analyze, or you can say that create a sales analyze report in the hospitality industry. Any confusion, any doubt in the sales analyze report? Because I have some more points on this, which I will just want to discuss with you. If any confusion till now, you can discuss with me. We will do discussion on this. Nobody?
No, sir.
Okay. No, sir. So, guys, we all do this for generating revenue. Okay, so sales analyze report, like we can also take POS. We can take some of the points from the point of sale. Point of sale. Anyone from your side? Last year we did point of sale, POS.
Like
it is a, yes,
the banquet halls,
sorry,
bars, sir, these are banquet halls.
POS, POS, point of sales. It's a basically, guys, it's kind